Hey, come to fans. Here we are at our Common Hockey Game of the Week, just in from the deep freeze all last week. And Doug Riegler, glad to see you warming up in Alberta.
Well, we were colder than back home, but now they're colder than us. But, you know, everyone was calling it the polar vortex. I was just calling it, it's winter.
Just another day for you Canadians, that's for sure. Yeah,
it was cold.
It was cold. It was a cold one. But Comet's back in town just for one game. Then next week they're out to the northeast of Canada for the triple rounder with Newfoundland. So that's a trip I don't really want to go on.
No easy way to get there. And when you get there, you know, you might as well play three games because it's not like you're going to make that trip that easy. And you know, the Growlers have been a top-notch team all year, so counting tonight and the next three games, you know, if we can go at least 500 or even win three of four, we'll be in good shape.
Well, we got a good one in here tonight. We got the Rapid City Rush out of South Dakota, a team that's always been kind of crazy to say they've been a rival, but they have been very tough against us. It's always been a good matchup. Seems that we're not too far away in the standings, but I expect a pretty good game tonight.
Well, a couple of us were talking, and this is the type of game that either there's going to be a lot of penalties or no penalties. I don't think there's going to be any in between. Rapid City's kind of got the reputation of they want to play on that edge, and a lot of times this year they've gone over the edge. Them and Allen usually getting a lot of guys suspended, so they try to intimidate you. I don't think it will happen, but you know, we've made some roster moves, so we'll see.
Well, we got one guy, Weiss, that got called up again to the American League, and good to see Campagna back. He's one I hated to see go. He's been playing so well.
Well, yeah, and you know, our players that have been excelling and are getting the chances up in the American Hockey League, that's what you want, but we need everyone we can.
Garrett Clark, another guy that we've just picked up, played over in Europe, and he played against him before, but he's just came back from Allen. I think he had 11 games with Allen, 55 minutes of penalties, so he's a guy that I definitely got to see in a Comet uniform.
Well, he's going to add that toughness that we need. We can't always rely on Crunk to do everything, and so, but even going towards playoffs, the stretch and everything, you got to have a tough team, and you got to be able to play all styles, and I think he'll be a good asset.
Well, Gary David doing a good job keeping up with the pace, trying to make the playoffs and be presentable in the playoffs. We'll be back with the start of the first period. Rapid City Rush here tonight.
Please welcome tonight's hometown hero, Michelle Ditton. Michelle is the Chief Nursing Officer and Executive Director of the Fort Wayne Sexual Assault Treatment Center and one of the founders of the organization, which was established in 1996. She has dedicated the majority of her career in the field of forensic nursing and promoting justice for adult and child victims of sexual assault. Tonight, Michelle is joined by her husband, children, and friends. The Comet organization and our fans would like to thank you for your advocacy for victims of sexual assault. Once again, please welcome Michelle Ditton. Now, fans, please rise and remove your hats and welcome Mike DePew with the playing of our national anthem. Thank you.
It's always a different type of rendition of the national anthem. Great job as usual. In goal tonight for the Rapid City Rush is Tyler Parks. He's got a 3.39 goals against average. He's down there in front of the bench itself there. He's played in 12 games. On the other end, we've got Eric Levine. He's got a 2.77 goals against. He's played in 6 games so far this season. Referees assigned by the ECHL are linesman Patrick Richardson wearing 82 on his back. Logan Bellegraff, number 85 on his back. And wearing the orange armbands, or Otto says, the floaties, Jacob R-E-K-U-C-K, Rikuki. We'll just say Jacob. So he's wearing number 20 in his back. Pretty good crowd in here, Doug Rigler. You know, there's a few sections, a lot of empty seats yet, but they're usually a late arriving crowd here in Fort Wayne.
Well, and then after the cold week where most of the kids were off school all week, everybody wants to get out of the house, and yep, what better place to take them at Harry Potter night here at the game, and hopefully we got good entertainment for the family.
Yes, sir. We got the uniforms will be auctioned off. The socks are kind of unusual. They usually just end up having the jerseys, but they got the socks tonight, too, to match.
Well, the thing I like, they got the big patches for the numbers, so the numbers are a little bit better to see compared to a lot of the souvenir
camouflage ones, yeah. Makes our job a little tougher.
And as my wife would say, that I have a hard time on the normal things, you know, with my reading glasses and everything, let alone having something obscure on the back of their jersey to pick out a number.
Yes, I understand what that means. We've got some scratches. Garrett Klotz for Rapid City, guy I like to see play here. He's a Regina boy. He's 6'5", size-wise. He's always in here, giving a good job to the Comets. And the Comets have got 6 big scratches. Of course, Justin Hodgman, one of the biggest on there, that still like to see him come back here and make his presence known.
Well, just got to make sure that his hand's completely healed before he comes back.
Rapid City with the rush right off the bat into the Comet zone. Turner gets it off behind the net. Off the boards with the Fend. Comets bring it out. Just dump it in as Gibson.
Put it right on net and get the whistle.
Which is not bad at all. Get a face off early.
Well, like we were talking before, Rapid City likes to play an up-tempo, very physical game. I had no doubt, and I want to bet with a couple of my buddies that Krunk would be one of the starting five, just in case Allen wanted to get a little stupid right off the bat. He's out there to keep guys honest.
Well, Rapid City only draws like 2,600 at home on the average, but they're pretty rabid fans. They're pretty crazy fans down there in South Dakota, where Mount Rushmore is. Good attack on the net. As Sidlowski is a little bit of a punch there.
Little love tap, cross check across the kidneys.
Right on the net, which means they got to blow the whistle for a face off. Nothing wrong with that. I'd rather see it go on the net than make the goaltender
exactly,
than just throw it away.
Well, and the thing is, you just never know when he might drop the puck, and we've had someone go into the net hard every time.
Yep. Face off to the left. Comes to get control. Gets blocked. Does he bring it back? Standing him up there, Petroselli. They get inside the zone. It's going to be a penalty on the Comets.
It'll be slashing or cross-checking?
It's like a slash. Comets with credit, 2 shots on goal.
It looks like we got our money's worth on the slash, because as Otto was saying in our ear, their player was coming off. I'd say it looked like he probably caught him right above where the glove ends, and elbow pad comes down. So as a player, you hated to get hit there. Yeah. There's a couple nerves in that area, and your hand just goes numb.
Well, and the cuffs on the gloves nowadays are considerably different than what they were when you were playing.
Oh, yeah. It's like big-time armor now.
The elbow pads come up a little bit more. Whoa, it just goes wide. Ooh, nice hit in the corner.
Nice hit by Cody.
Rapid City in a power play. On the far side. Well, tried to get it on the far side. They blocked it.
Forwards switching around.
Give me your second one.
Can't get running around too much. But I was just kind of looking at who's got all the penalties for them. 25. Morasti. Imagine that with that name.
That's a not like the one we were talking about previous to the game. And they get tipped in. It's going to be a face-off inside or outside the blue line.
Morasti and Klotz are two of their players that have the most penalties. But Morasti's name spelled a little bit different than Nasty Morasti from in the past, who now is playing for a senior team in my hometown.
Can you believe that? Oh, my gosh.
Brought in for his toughness and his craziness.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure the finesse players for the Athletics in Grand Prairie are extremely happy that he's on their team.
Yeah. Although when he played here, he wasn't really out there hacking and stuff, but I'll tell you, when there was any physical play, he was right there on top of it. He only played about 14 games for the Comets.
Yeah, and he wasn't afraid to fight.
Oh, yeah.
And he could fight.
Nice little dump into the zone with Sadowski. 7:15 to go in period number one. 35 seconds to go in the penalty. Pushing the play there. Wah. Good to see him back. Comet uniform.
Yeah, if we could get everybody back, I think we'd have a pretty solid lineup.
Rapids. Oh, good hit there. Oh, now wait a minute. He just barely bumped him.
That's going to get a board.
That's a poor call. He turned on him the same time he
hit him too hard.
Boarding penalty.
Yeah.
That's going to Brady Shaw. You watch this and watch our replay. Yeah, that
would have been shoulder to shoulder. Their guy turned a little bit. And
pretty weak. Face off to the right of Eric Levine.
Got 17 seconds left on our first penalty, so hopefully we can win the face off, get it down. Or they can win it and get it all the way back. That was a
good face off there.
Shaquille Morasti on the face off, so I expect that he'll
be. Nice poke check.
There we go. Good job. I like the fact that he just hung on to the puck along the boards.
That's our captain, Jamie Schausma, doing that. Nice Harbin off the board. Oh! Well, I thought for sure that was outside the blue line. And it goes all the way down. There's why you go to the net, Doug. Out to the pole.
Nope. No problem with that.
I see what you're saying, yeah.
If we weren't shorthanded, but everybody was down low, no use just giving the puck right away, pull it back, waste about 30 seconds.
Parks kind of mishandled that one behind the net. There's a good one. I think we got away with that one. Could have been a holding out in front. Nice hold again. Nice pass. Nice wrist shot. This goes wide.
Here's interference.
Not very consistent. And they're going to call that offside. Activity going on in front of the net.
Yeah, 14 took a chop at Cody because they like getting chopped.
5'14", Tyler Poulsen, 5'6".
Jeez.
That's a short player.
Well,
and he's going to the box.
Well, and he should. He took a slash.
Comet fans getting a little razzies to the officials there. Face off
good
to the
call.
Right of Parks.
Sure this ref wants to keep a tight rein on all the stupid stuff, the stick work and everything.
Thomas trying to push the play.
Oh, yeah. Got to get back.
Okay, they're covering it pretty good. Nice tip there by Camras.
It's nice to see him back in the lineup.
Oh, yeah. Nice, slow it down
slow
a little
down.
Bit.
Slow it down. Going to be a power play here in about 3 seconds.
There it is. Comets are full strength now. Comets with a 15% power play. Not really exciting there.
Yeah, we on our stretch where we nice play.
Nice. Oh, boy.
Went off a skate.
Yep.
When we kind of went on our skid, then our power play went with it.
Lowney out of the far side. Nice back to Lowney. There's that drop back. Sidlowski ever in the corner. Played it nicely there.
Oh, trying to forward.
And it got free a little bit as quick to respond there was Richard Coyne, defenseman.
Well, where did he play last year?
Coyne?
Yeah.
That name sounded really familiar. I didn't bring that, get that stick upstairs.
I don't know if it was like
Coyne.
Kalamazoo or it was somewhere where we played quite a bit. So the name sounds very familiar.
Out to the point. Got tipped there. Oh, good play,
right
though.
Idea.
Good effort. Petroselli out to the point. Oh, right there. Oh, boy.
That was a shot.
Yep, that was it.
They just got to be ready for it on the far side because he was... That shot was for the rebound.
That's for sure. Perfect. Nice little tip in. Nice poke there. Goes to the far side.
14 looking over his shoulder.
And they blast it all the way down. Levine hangs on to that one for a moment. Saul with it. Up the boards, watch too many men on the ice. Ooh, nice pick off there. Camras with it, inside, left side. Oh, just goes wide. Would you see him turn around looking? Got hit anyway. Nice big
Tempo's,
hit there by
Tempo's
Ciro.
Picking up here.
They're onside.
Crunk throwing it in. Their goalie having a little trouble hanging on to it. Crunk ran him over again.
Oh, should be a holding there. He went down. Oh,
okay,
here
we go.
Crunk wasn't going to lose that battle. Nice move there on the stick.
Oh, look, look.
That's all he's trying to do, but just not successful. Bringing into the zone is Mercier. He goes into the boards. Ooh, nice pick around the net. I like that.
Had the right idea, just puck took a funny bounce.
Kept it in. Nice stop. Get a face off to the right of goaltender Tyler Parks.
Well, the tempo's definitely picking up. It's getting a little more choppy out there. They got guys that don't like to get hit.
11:45 to go in period number one. Comets with eight shots to Rapid City's two shots on goal. Who just out of the reach. Getting bumped into the boards there was Trey Phillips. Guy, I don't think he only played maybe one game at home since he's been here. Been a scratch most of the time.
77 for them. He's got quite a few penalty minutes, but see, he's got a cage on him. Probably worse for wear for from a fight or whatever.
Petroselli right there, north nice side of the boards there. Yeah, just coming off the bench. Icing Rapid City goes back down to the other end.
Yeah, 77, Michael Turner, good-sized boy.
Yeah.
They got a lot of big boys, but, you know, 3 goals, 5 assists in 38 games. And he's minus 16, so that's a line that wow. You want to take advantage of.
Then we get thrown out. Come on. No, I guess not.
Yep.
Chasma. Ciro goes in for the faceoff. Rapid City just chips it out of the zone. Nice, off the boards. Camras goes in deep. Yeah, carrying it on into the area.
Little recreation.
I would like to see Ciro in there. I like to see him get physical. He's a big boy. Still no score.
Looks like one and one. One from theirs, one from ours. We can live with that. Guy wants to drive to the front of the net. Make him pay.
Few words being said over there, I think, by Jamie Schaffsma.
Llewellyn is going into the box for them and doesn't have a whole lot of penalty minutes, but.
Well, he wasn't the first one in there. The first one was a small player of theirs, I think.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Good tempo. They're not going to come into our rink and set the tempo and their toughness. 4-on-4.
Face off left of Eric Levine. Picking up is Sadlowski. Fakes the going in.
Spread everybody out and get some speed.
Boy, he handles the puck so well. Yeah, we got it in the zone, and that's what's important. Ah.
Lost the puck.
And we pick it back up again.
Here we go.
Phillips dropping it off. On the near side. Binkley, nice shot.
Oh. Baptista just lost it.
Yeah. Got 1:22 left in the power play. Face off inside the Rapid City zone. Again, Doug, I say that Rapid City only drawing 2,600 people. And you look at the Comets leading the league. I really don't know how they can afford all that travel and everything else when you're.
Makes it tough, even if they get all the concessions and all the parking.
Yeah.
I mean, Kalamazoo seems to survive with the owner owning the building and everything, but.
Yeah.
But it does make it tough.
Yeah, I just don't know how they do it. Anything under 3,500, I think, would be to me the almost the max off, you know, as far as that goes. But what do I know? Comets with it inside the zone. Nice move there.
Too many moves.
Couldn't bring it with him. Campagna. Lowney back. Gets behind the net. 48 seconds to go in the penalty. Well, we're not going anywhere back there right now. There we go. And it's a dump in right on the goaltender. Now we get a faceoff inside the zone. That's understandable with the TV timeout. 9:12 remaining in period number one.
You know, and you look at Rapid City's record, they actually have a better record on the road than they do at home. They're 8-13-1-2 at home and 9-11-3-1 on the road. You know, they're just a team that's probably, the results are based on how they play. They, from what I've been able to read on them, they take themselves out a lot of games by taking stupid penalties. They've had a few guys get suspended and everything. Again, they are in the same division as Allen, so, you know, you fight fire with fire, but, yeah. You know, they do have some talent on their team, but, again, just like us, not playing consistent, and they'll lose a lot of close games.
Well, I've really been saying all season long, of course, we've Martineau's been called up, Weiss been called up, and, of course, Campagna's back after a quick call-up, and unfortunate for him, but... you know, I still think we've got some really talented guys. We just can't seem to get it together.
Well, we just need everyone to make that sacrifice to put team first, not just individual performances, and buy in and do the little things. Because even with the talent we have to play kind of the lunch bucket type game of just winning it ugly.
Oh, there's a mistake. And with Hodgman out, I mean, Hodgman out could, you know, and Sadowski both, Sadowski coming in after the season started, no doubt, but still, two players that could compete for the MVP of the. Oh boy, just goes wide.
Yep. Good.
He
good
was going
dig.
Backward, trying to dig on that one.
But like you say, Hodgman has been our best player all year. I mean, he's been very consistent. There's times we get frustrated with him on when he's kind of whining about a non-call, but
right.
he has played up to what we expected. With the skill level that he has.
Well, bringing it back.
You know, David and them have to be happy with the results they're getting from him.
Dumped in.
Good strength.
Nice control. Oh boy, it just about deflected in. Nice hit in the corner. Nice little bump there. Just about watching it's going to go off a skate there as the referee was right there on top of it.
Yeah, he's right on it.
Comet's keeping him keeping that slot pretty well cleared out.
Yeah, we're not letting him have any chances out there.
Comet's clearing it. Putting the pressure on there was Campagna.
You know, we've had lots of time to look at video and know what they're going to be doing.
Saul just takes a swipe at it, gets it back down. Off the boards. I'm not sure what Saul did that one for. Trying to play it.
But Saul and number 14, they're just kind of chopping at each other.
Campaign, they're bringing it back. Saul with it.
Got Sadowski at the far blue line, stretching their defense out.
Comet's out shooting, Doug, 11-3. That's still pretty good. Not a lot of great quality shots, but at least they're making the goaltender move on them. Here we go. Good. On the near side. And a follow through. Out to the point. Binkley with it, far side.
Oh, almost bounced off the leg.
Nice pass over there from Brady Shaw, the far side. Right down the middle. Oh, there we go.
Beautiful goal.
That was a great 1-2 go.
good, quick little passes. Didn't even shoot it, just redirected it. Had the goalie moving side to side. Great finish on that play.
Right, it looked like it was a 5-0, Doug, didn't it?
No, went up over his blocker.
Oh, did it go up?
Well, and the thing was, the guy driving to the net had his stick on the ice.
Wow, I believe gets credit for that goal. Yeah, okay. Comets on the board, 5:55 to go in period number one. Petruzzelli. And Phillips with the assist.
Nice turnaround.
Nice little tip into the zone.
Nope, Sestron giving it 77 little chop.
Can't keep it in. Nice giving that one back. Here's Sidlowski. Oh, right there. Oh, and then we get a little extra there. Let's see if goaltender loses his helmet. That's automatic whistle.
I like Baptista driving to the net.
Few words spoken there by Richard Coyne. Like you said, Doug, a lot of these guys play against each other. They know their tendencies for the most part. From maybe we going back way back to junior, if you might.
And in some cases, even blow that Bantaman midget hockey that. You know, but the thing I liked was Baptista was driving to the net.
Yep.
His goaltender's having trouble with his rebounds. We're going to be able to tuck a couple if we keep going to the net like we are.
And if you're thinking Parkson's like a big goaltender down there, he is. He's 6'7". That's pretty big. Sometimes they have a tendency to not move as well. Nice wrist shot. A little trouble with it. He's hanging on to it. Comets, oh, right here in front, Otto. You're right there on it.
Got sucked into a penalty. It should have been both of them. Their guy's getting off the ice like a little
Fend?
Coward.
Is that Fend?
I think so.
93.
Got the mask on, and I don't see why the ref didn't take both of them.
Yeah,
there's enough chopping
either.
Both ways. I know Sid gave the last punch to the head, but.
I think that's what Shasma was asking about right now.
You know, Finn wants to, Gary's asking him the same thing. It's like all the crap that went up the ice that both
right.
of them were chopping at each other, just send them both off. And I'm sure that's what Gary's asking him, like, hey, all the crap that went on up the ice, both of them chopping and, I'm not saying my guy's innocent, but they both should go, not just
right.
one.
I wonder if the referee's saying, well, I was watching the play up there and I just saw the retaliation, so. Ben Boudreau over there talking to the defensive core.
Oh, and that's what I don't like. Okay, now you think you got to go give the other guy an explanation?
Yeah.
Just make the call and move on.
Yeah.
If you got to explain yourself, then you're losing control.
Oh, yeah. And I figured it should have stopped when we talked to Shasma. It should have really stopped right then. Out in front. I tried to get that one cleared. And that goes all the way down. Comets on the penalty kill. Comets penalty kill is 83% as the power play for Rapid City is 16%. Obviously, it'd be nice to get up there into 25% if you got a power play, but there we go, throwing it all the way back
down. Even up in the 90s on penalty killing.
Yep. Four 16 to go in the period. Comets up 1-0. And I thought they're going to get it in deeper than that. And Binkley doing a good job of hacking in there. Petrucelli putting a little pressure on there.
Yeah, we're not letting them have any time to get set up.
And Petrucelli trying to anticipate the play, and they went ahead and were going to pass to the guy Petrucelli was on, but he had been covered, so they took it behind the net.
Yeah, their power play is only a little bit better than ours.
Nice job there.
Oh.
You shoot it in the net?
I was hoping it was going to hit the net, because if it would have went over the glass, it would have been a penalty.
You know, face off right in front of the Comet bench. Again, it's Harry Potter night. Now some of those seats like over in lower 222 have filled in. That was really vacant when the game started.
Maybe that section there all in the lounge.
Possibly.
Supporting the Coliseum.
There you go. Ooh, I'll give him a little extra push there. He's putting the pressure on now offensively. Camras puts a little pressure on. Levine slows it down. Oh, can't get it out. Camras knocked down, not too happy with no call there being made.
Yeah, we just got to be smart
now. Bringing it in there is Mercier. Mercier to left side. Tries to go for the top corner on that one.
Trying to see if the goalie would cheat. And
well, they kept it in. Here's Sadowski. Oh, nice. He just so smooth.
He does. Makes it look so easy.
Oh, boy. Just lost it in front.
Good thing their goalie was paying attention.
Yes, Parks was right there and put the old stick down and the glove on top of it. 2:24 to go in period number one. Comets out shooting Rapid City 18-6. And like you said, some of those have made the goaltender go back and forth and be pretty active in there to keep that puck out of the net.
Well, after having such a long layoff, I really like the tempo that our guys are playing, because a lot
exactly.
of times you see a little rust.
Yeah.
But these guys definitely are skating hard.
Well, we've talked about before, you cannot take, I don't care what position the team you're playing that night is in. Oh, here we go. Anybody can beat anybody in a given night, so it's always, you got to come to play. Ah, come on. Don't forget. They're going to give that a hand pass in the defensive zone.
I think we got lucky, because I thought it went off one of our guys.
Yeah. That's what I thought. Be outside the
blue line. We'll take the face off.
Of course, my partner tonight, don't forget, scored 44 goals in the old IHL back in the days when they still had the red line. When you still had to be able to handle the puck.
Good thing I had wingers that could do that.
Oh, Dougie. Yeah, I'm very, very proud of you. I had to end up talking to Kaylee Schrock the other day for about 45 minutes, poor guy. But talked to him a lot about the youth coming up in Fort Wayne, and so proud of his progress and success, I should say.
Yeah, now he's up at Trine University. And
yep.
Building the program up there. They got a nice hockey program and beautiful new rink.
Boy, Petrucelli heads up there, Doug.
Oh, he's flying everywhere.
He is just all over the place. Very good, smart defensive move there.
Too many men.
Too many men is... quickly to point that out with Schaffsma, as he had the old arm up, counting him off. As
even in Harry Potter land, that was still too many men. No magic
listen
wand.
Listen to you, like you're the big observance of Harry Potter.
My kids watched it. I did.
Yeah.
I have no idea.
You and I both admitted that we've never seen any of the Harry Potter stuff.
So last minute, 13 seconds. We're on the power play. Let's get some
let's
chances
get some
here. See what we
here.
Can do.
There's Ryan Lowney out on the point on defense. He's got Campagna on his left side. Going with four forwards out there, it looks like.
Rapid City been doing a...
Oh, boy, did that come close. Great move there by Sidlowski, Doug. You don't see that too often, a guy to throw his body down like
well,
that.
Still trying to get the puck away from them
That's
so
right.
they didn't have a chance. The last thing we want to do is give them an odd man rush.
That's right. Great effort by Sean Sidlowski. They bring it in. Right back out to the point. Here's Sidlowski with it now. Boy, did you see that? He didn't even look. He made that nice pass.
He knew exactly where he was at.
Look at the head up. Ah, bounced over his stick with 33 seconds to go.
There we go.
Here's Sidlowski on the left side. Boomer. Oh, right down the middle. Can we keep it in? Oh, boy. Parks comes up with the old
save
there.
But nice heavy shot by Sidlowski. And the thing I like is we got guys going to the net. Rapid City's doing a good job of tying up our six so that we're not having a good second chance, but we've got guys there.
And you like the idea that Parks is not being able to control those rebounds that came out there. And if we keep going to the net, we're going to get those.
We're going to get one or two. And I like Solowski's nice heavy shot, going for the rebound.
22.9 in the period left. Camras in the corner. Trying to get it going. And Petroselli in there too. Out to the point. Oh, good shot though by Brady Shaw.
Running
out to the point.
0.5 seconds left. Kind of just dropped the puck and
go
to the locker room.
Well, good first period. Both teams are playing fairly well, I think.
Well, the thing I like also in our zone, we're taking away the slot and the shooting lane that we're not really giving in Rapid City any good chances to get quality shots.
Well, that'll do it for period number one. Comets won the Rapid City Rush, nothing. Comets out shooting them 21-7, Doug.
Well, like you said, part of our shots early, we're just putting the puck to the net, but we started getting some good quality chances. Their goaltender came up with some big saves, but we just got to keep playing the way we are. I've been real pleased with how we come out after a long layoff.
Start of a game that we'll be playing next week up in Newfoundland, so let's see if we can't do something in this next period.
Comet fans, you want to listen a little bit more beyond Comet Game of the Week on Wednesday nights on Access Fort Wayne? We have a new show on WELT produced by the Comets called Cometcast.
I am your host, Shane Alberani. You know me from doing the play-by-play on WoWo throughout the season, but now I'm adding podcast host to the old resume. Keep an eye out on social media, Twitter, and Facebook for who our next guest is going to be.
Join Shane Tuesday mornings at 9 a.m. for Cometcast on WELT.
And we're back with period number three, and Doug Rigler and I were both talking to David and Tina Franke, the general manager and wife of the Fort Wayne Comets. And I told Doug, I said, it's too bad you weren't playing for that guy when you were playing here in Fort Wayne. So
might have got my last check in bonuses.
Yeah, that's very sad and unfortunate. But you did get a bonus with Lynn you got married to, so without Doug.
Well, I was already married before the last year with Brad.
Oh, that's
so.
Right, that's right. But good first period for the Comets. David says, yeah, it's been a good first period. I talked about the refereeing a little bit there, and he said, yeah, it's pretty bad when you got to go explain yourself to both coaches when you make a call. But that's what this league is about, a lot of learning experience, not just for the players but for the referees too. So
yeah, everyone's trying to work their way up into the higher levels. So
you some kind of wonder, though, what the deal is.
Well, it's no different than when you look at different players that, you know, on different teams that struggled. You know, inconsistencies or whatever. Same thing for the officials, unfortunately.
Yeah, Binkley brings it all the way into the offensive zone. Nice job by Kamaras there as the Comets
spread it out a little bit.
Hold on to a power play here. Ooh, nice try to feed on that one. Out to the point, Binkley. Run out of time.
Nice deflection.
Yeah, Comets can't. It's full strength now as Rapid City's
putting the pressure
out
on
of the net. Binkley with it. He's off the boards.
Smart play. He didn't have anyone to pass to, so.
That goes behind the net. Here's Binkley again. Pass right up the middle. They were not able to keep it into the zone. Picking it off there is Elms. Into the zone. Nice hip check by Cody Saul.
Yeah, both teams going to the body very well.
Comets out shooting me, as they said, 21 to 7 in the first period. Nice follow through. Rapid City takes that shot, goes to the net. Had nothing to say about that move.
Ref yelling at him. He took an extra little chop. Thought the puck was loose, but the only thing I like about that was you played to the whistle.
That's right. That's right. 18:09 to go in period number two.
If our defenseman thought he was taking liberties, I'm sure he would have went and had a chat with him.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, David said they wanted to get manned up. I said something about Clark was the one that really impressed me the most out of the additions that they made this week. And he said, well, we wanted to get manned up to go to Newfoundland. He says, we've got three games out there. We didn't want to be having an injury or two and get shorthanded. So.
Well, and like we've talked, you know, it is way out on the East Coast. No easy way to get there. So if you do end up shorthanded, there's no easy way to bring a player in. So smart play on their part. Like you say, get a full roster, because then you can worry about when guys start getting returned or healthy, what you got to do with the numbers.
Yeah, David said they're taking a sleeper into Toronto and then flying out of Toronto into St. John's, Newfoundland.
What do you mean a sleeper? That's a seven-hour bus trip. You don't need a sleeper for a seven-hour trip. Kids are getting soft, Randy.
Oh, I know. I know.
Now I can see if they're busing all the way out to Newfoundland, but
yeah,
that's a whole other world.
Lowney, nice job. I like Lowney's job on that one, Doug. He laid it right across on the blue line instead of throwing it back. Let the skater skate into the pass. Yep, that's going to be all the way down. And Levine going to hang on to it behind the net.
Gotta watch the guy coming up behind you.
Nice dump by Lowney. Nice hit there as Kamaras spread the body and took that nice check.
Give him a saddle.
Now picking
good job
it up
by Shaw.
Shaw there.
Someone take the puck.
A little communication there. Here
puck
we go.
Puck is kind of bouncing now all over the
back
place.
A nice. Here's Wah with it in the corner. Going a little high there. That's out to the point. Offside as they stepping into it. Nice deflection. Rapid City in deep. Out to
putting
the point.
Putting some pressure.
Nice
good
outlet.
Good job.
Nice outlet. Shaw with it. Just dumps
coming
it in.
Going for a change.
Going off. 16 minutes even to go in period number two. Comets out shooting him 22-9. Still only 1-0. As they drop back in. Wait for someone to pass to. And that's going to be
Thought that would have been icing. It was their guy that.
That's what I thought. They waved it off. The referee made a kind of unusual move.
Well, a lot
there.
Of times, anytime their player from either team are just tying up sticks, if it goes by, they'll wave it off for whatever reason. Go to the body.
Nice stepping into that one. A lot of miscues there. Cody Saul getting bumped there. He didn't retaliate, which is good.
Well, yeah, it was a good, clean check. So.
Yep, they went both went off.
You know, so many guys in so many leagues now, a routine, normal check, and all of a sudden someone's got a fight.
Oh, yeah. Nice. Can we keep? Yeah, we get possession of it. Seskon taking the body.
Those two big boys.
Yeah. I was impressed with that one. As Kamras is on his way to the far blue line.
Seskon throwing his weight around, which is exactly what we need.
Off the boards. Picking it up there is Wislowski.
Because nobody really messes with him, and rightfully so.
Yeah. Well, Stewart gone. Seskon definitely picked up where Stewart left off. As
got to
get
bodies
City
back.
Three
on three, three on four.
Going right to the boards. Oh, got three on two if we get something going. Onside. Oh! Kamras just.
Trying to kick it up to his stick, but I like Baptista went to the net.
Yeah, that was a good play there. Just thrown in on the goaltender. It was Marasti. Big boy, Marasti.
Yeah, good size boy, but
6'5", 220.
Good tempo this period as well.
Well, this is the night, Doug. We've done it before. We've blown games that we've had great crowds in here, like New Year's Eve. We should have beat Brampton that night. We really sat about a period and a half, if not a little bit longer, then we finally started playing the game. We got beat that night with a great crowd. Now is tonight's one that we need to impress these people. They're going to want to come back and see a Comet win.
Well, and so far this game, we've been playing very well. Good tempo. Guys are working hard. Nothing really stupid out there. But good effort by everybody. And really, there's no excuse that the effort shouldn't be there because we've had a long layoff.
Exactly.
Everyone's well rested.
Lowney behind the net. Nice pickup there. Boy, Petrocelli putting the pressure on. Still onside. As we're going after it is Quayle. Quayle with it. Up the left side. Ooh, I thought that was offside.
Wow.
One of those nice and close.
They have to clear the pond.
Get a line change going here. Yeah, we're going to be going into a... A rough part of the schedule, time of year, where a lot of things are always going on in the building, so we'll be on the road.
They're going to call it offside. I think he better realize who he's going with.
Oh, I think he did.
That's coin in there, it looks like. 24. 6'1", 216. Pretty good sized kid, but... The old lefty down there, Taylor Crunk. Well, Crunk is one of those guys, we've said it before, Doug, that really surprises you. He's not, just not the physical play. He's got some hands. He can handle the puck and not afraid to take it to the net.
And he's not afraid to drop the gloves when he needs to.
Yeah.
Doesn't
sure.
do any talking. He just lets the fist do the talking. And really, it's just kind of the old school way that if you're going to fight, just fight.
Yep. Coin out to the point. Oh, nice job. I said that was a Ciro, I guess. Boy, sure. Saul really pushing it right there.
Here we go.
And just got done talking about it. Coin and Oh, boy, left-handed. And?
Well, and the thing I like there, they when they went down to the ice, Clark could have got in one or two more shots.
Yeah. Yep.
But kind of that unwritten rule, and a lot of people don't understand it with the heavyweights, that, yeah, I want to beat you and I want to kick your butt, but I'm going to do it man-to-man. I don't want an extra advantage. Unless there's some real bad blood, then all bets are off. And
well, Kronk has definitely been noted for having that ferocious left hand, and he just proved it again there.
Well, and their guy was a heavyweight as well, so.
And again, those guys have definitely experienced each other's presence before. It's not like you play them one time a year and then that's. And he got a right hand on the Kronk, but nothing at all like that left-handed.
Then he missed with one and they went down. But, I don't think it will be the last we've seen of that duo.
You're probably right there.
You know, but Kronk wants to make his presence known.
Well, it definitely frees up your real estate when you get in front there. Oh, boy, right in front. Nice backhand there with Sidlowski. Nice pull down, too, there was Quayle. As Rapid City brings it out, nice throwing into the Lebinger. Nice off the boards. Good job.
In the far side,
yeah. Out to the point. Oh, that's up in the netting.
Up in the stands?
Up in the stands, yeah.
Good, just missed the corner of the netting. Where people have to be paying attention all the time.
Oh, yeah. Well, unfortunately, a lady in Columbus, Ohio, in the NHL game, and my friend Claude Wickenheiser's daughter suffered a nasty injury to the head, getting hit, and because of those, that's why the netting is down there. A lot of people complained at first, but it just is almost invisible once you get used to it.
With the technology, and safety is utmost because that puck is moving so fast and it can be so deadly. Just like a month ago, it was Justin Hodgman's niece that got hit on the side when we were trying to figure out what happened. Well, they'd already took her out, so luckily nothing happened to her and she had full recovery.
Well, I never understood why for so many years and forever it was never protected like it is now. As Cummins bring it back into the defensive zone on the near side. Petroselli on the side took the body. Lowney with a nice poke check. Here's Shaw drops it back. And they get it outside.
I think it was more of a loss of the puck.
Kind of lost it. I made it look like a drop back, but They try to dump it in there. Right on the blue line. Nice
a
little
kick save. Kick save and a beauty.
Yes. Lowney in the corner. Notice how Lowney straddles that body and
getting body position where at his size he can And the guy.
Was, the guy was bigger than him, yeah.
That's a lot bigger.
A lot bigger. So, yeah, it's all the way you position your body. Nice shot all the way around to the far side. Comet's onside. Ooh, trying to go to the far side to camera as he does. Freed the puck up a little bit. Can we keep it in?
That's good job by Cody.
Yeah.
Put the puck back in. We would have taken an offside.
Ooh.
Linesman was awfully quick to wave that one off.
Comet's still out shooting him 25-10.
Oh, here we go.
Right down the middle.
Chastman was hoping someone was with him.
Yeah, he was.
Good body check.
No, it got outside anyway. Kamras just throws it back to defense.
Oh.
Still onside. Brings it back. Polson gives it back to his defense. Wazowski with it now. Goes up, trying to go up the middle.
Good body check.
Yeah, I liked how he stepped into that one. And we're getting a slash.
I don't know where the slash was at.
I don't either, because
they get it or we get it.
Visitor's bench goes open.
Campagna
getting it. Well, I totally missed that one. Totally missed that one.
I'm not sure where it happened. I was watching the play, and it must have been behind the play with some give and take. A lot of that going on out there.
Yeah, because he was the guy that took the guy into the boards to slow the play down a little bit, and then we get the whistle. Yeah, that would be my job, Doug, with the white outfit.
The old rabbit game?
Is that what that is? Oh. 9:07 remaining in period number two. Comets with a 1-0 lead over Rapid City. Out shooting him 25-10 right now.
Well, I'm sure all the Harry Potter people are loving the different references and the games going on. And a great job by the Comet staff of putting something together that I'm sure we have some fans here that it might be their first game to a Comet, to watch Comet hockey, and were brought in because of the Harry Potter theme.
Well, your daughters have been on the staff of the Comets and been part of that intermission and timeout festivities, I guess I should say. Your one daughter's still dancing in college. I see that every once in a while.
My youngest one going up to watch her compete tomorrow. And they're up in Grand Rapids. Oh, here we go, going to the net. Great thing about the college competition, it's like short and sweet, and then you can leave.
It's over with, huh? Nice going, nice shot. Goes wide. Wazowski on the point.
Killing the penalty here.
Here's Wazowski again, right down the middle. Batista, boy, got that net moved a little bit. On the near side, Comets keeping that middle of the net.
Yeah, they keep one guy area down low in the slot.
Mercier. See, we can't keep it at...
Everyone thought it was going to be going up into the
here
net.
Here we go. 3-on-2 if we get something going. Far side.
Good job by Sean just to hang on to the puck and kill it off as much time as possible.
Nice poke check there. Nice shot, got it off. On the boards is Gibson. All the way down. Shaw going out there, put some pressure on.
He's got some speed.
Yeah, he does. He's going for the puck there. They won't call that. That's good. That should be an icing. And it is. As it comes all the way back down with 27 seconds to go in the penalty.
But, yeah, we've been doing a good job on keeping them off balance because it seems they love to try going right into the middle of the slot, and we've got one guy that collapses right down there. And we're letting our other forward, he's kind of working both the defensemen, but we don't leave that open spot because they tried doing the high deflection or trying to feed that guy for a quick shot.
Well, Comet's putting the pressure on him. The old arm grab there as we hustle back. Quickly dump it in. Gibson on the near side as they get possession of it again. Five seconds to go in the penalty. Got one guy hanging on the side of the net down the middle.
5-on-5. Everyone just takes someone.
Well, you got to make him pay there. There we go. Morasti tried to hang on that post.
And chop it to loose pucks. Yeah, we've got to knock him down.
Morasti, 6'5", 220. Only
not,
27.
Not that easy of a target to move.
Yeah, that's for sure.
A lot of beef. And, of course, you know, you look at his penalty minutes. You know, he's up there near the top on their team. So he plays that tough type style. He's going to the front of the net. Levine's asking the ref, like, how many times are you going to let him chop after the whistle?
Yeah, Turner's out there just in the bottom. There he is, just pulls in there. Like a minus 16, I think you've already said that. 84 minutes in penalties, not too shabby. The penalties kind of show you how aggressive the guy is. That's kind of what we're trying to highlight. It's not necessarily a good follow through. And that was Sidlowski. As we pick it up.
It's Ciro over there?
Ciro. I'm sorry, I said Sidlowski. Oh, he's upset. Got a penalty for a delay of game. Somebody got popped, too. Oh. That's sad.
That's coming up near our seats.
Yep. Well, it looks like Lowney's going to the box for a delay game.
Common penalty. Number 71, Ryan Lowney. 2 minutes delay of the game. Got a penalty 15 minutes.
Yeah, people, you come up to a common game, you got to pay attention to the game. You're down that lower arena area. Got to be.
Well, if it's in the area, I'm thinking there's a lot of nurses that sit down in that area, so someone should be able to help someone out.
Yeah, hopefully it's nothing
serious. Nothing too serious.
Comet's going to try to kill this one off again.
Yeah, we're giving them a little too many chances.
There we go. Batista, nice job there. Little hook, no call. Batista got hooked.
Big time.
Should have been
the ref was so far behind the play that I'm sure he couldn't really see it.
Sidlowski, far side, nice job. Throws it all the way down.
Makes it look so smooth, doesn't
it? Yeah, yeah. Just tremendous anticipation. Here's Waugh going in there.
Waugh skates hard.
On the near side. Risha, nice kick save. Let's watch the rebound. Shaw taking it.
Here's a hold.
Putting the pressure on him. Turner throws it back to Coin. Coin with it. Coin over the goal line. Far side to Lebinger.
I think it was Coin and they went with Krunk. So we'll see if that
Comet's doing a good job in the neutral zone, Doug.
Putting a lot of pressure, not letting them get anywhere.
That is some good pressure. Even Petroselli there, nice job. Nice poke check by Saul.
Down to the last 10 seconds.
On the far side. Nice deflection there. It went up the netting. Face off inside the zone, I believe.
But a good job in front of the net.
Well, I also like that kick save that Levine had there, the Comets goaltender. Had a nice kick save, directed it to the far side where there's no one there.
Well, and that's so critical because they're trying to get that rebound to come straight out in the slot. And even if it did, we had guys that were tying up their sticks. But Seskon kind of threw Turner around like he was a rag doll in front of the net there at the whistle. I think Seskon's about the only one that could really do that because Turner's a pretty good-sized boy.
The
Cummins bring it out. Into the zone. Nice to hold on to it long like that. Campagna!
They're going to get a penalty.
It's a slash. Well, he likes that slash, doesn't he?
He does. Could have been slash, holding, yeah. Interference.
Yeah.
But he loves his slash. I think it's his call of the game.
He just likes that move of the quick slice to the arm. Going to the box is Morasti.
You know, again, by putting the pressure towards the net, we force them into a penalty. So now we just got to take advantage of it. Winning the faceoff is going to be a big start. Rapid City does very well on their faceoffs tonight, so we got to start.
Well, Rapid City comes in here with 17-24, 4-3 record for 41 points. Comets with a 22-17, 1-2, 47 points. But nice job throwing it down.
It was almost a little dangerous to give them.
I just Ray say it looked a little bit, little too slow, that pass there. I'm not sure what that was about.
Now it's their turn to be putting pressure on us. Now yeah. Get it set up. There we go. Don't Here's skate back into them.
Lowney. Or that was the Binkley, I'm sorry. Oh. Out to the point. Nice job by Waugh. Back to Waugh in the corner. Out to the point. Far side. Oh, I thought they were going to keep it in for a moment. Waugh slowing it down. Camras. Now they're getting a little too fancy. Just shoot the puck, guys.
Oh, there's a play. That was the play we wanted.
Yeah. Just playing with it there was Montemy. There he goes. Sidlowski takes his, there we go, bringing it back.
Got to be ready anytime with Sid.
Oh, yeah. All the way around to the near side.
Spread him out.
Batista with it. Out to the point. Camras.
Campagna.
Campagna, I should have said. Back out to the point. Got deflected there. Sadowski. Back to Batista. Try to get it to him. There's a little interference. Go for him. There you go. Campagna with it.
Boy, Levine, go to the body.
Levine hung onto that post there.
That's where you got to stop and go.
Off the boards. Morasti in the corner with Batista. Campagna with it. On the boards, far side.
Here we go. 3-on-3. Need to get a line change here.
Waugh follows it behind.
Oh, getting too fancy. Throw it at the net.
Come on, let's get.
There's a trip. Yep.
Thank you. We don't get a follow-up penalty there as Alec Bear went down in front of the Comet bench with Kronk standing there. Nothing's going to happen there as Bear skates over with the referee, a linesman behind him. 52.9, Doug. We get one here right now. It would be nice to end the period.
Yeah, we just need to start getting some shots on our power play. They're taking away what we're trying to do, so we just have to make some adjustments and just simply get the puck to the net, because we're giving this goalie an easy period. We've played very well, but they're getting in the shooting and passing lanes.
Well, Saul had the guy beat there, and he went trying to make that fancy pass that tried to thread that needle. Not to the point.
Get the puck moving quick. Get him.
Sidlowski. Campagna. Oh, boy. Got
good.
Deflected there.
Well, got a goalie got a stick on it.
Comes all the way back. Lowney with it.
Here got we go. Got one guy
one
caught.
More rush. Oh.
Nice job just moving it.
Out to the point. 9 seconds to go.
Big save by their goalie.
0.6 seconds to go. Well, he's made the difference here in the last half a minute or so.
Yeah, I've been real happy on this power play, even though we haven't scored a goal, that we've had some great shots, good puck movement, and now at least we're having a sense of urgency to get the puck to the net.
Yeah, before we were just taking too much time and trying to go for that perfect shot. And well, goaltender's off. That's a good move.
Yeah, there's not going to be enough time for the puck to get down the ice before the whistle or before the puck could cross the line at the end of the period. So just try winning it.
Try to get this face off. Boy, and it went right to the net, too. So good move by Gary Grant behind the bench.
Yeah, Sid was just trying to get a bounce, but I thought this is one of our better second periods. It's usually been the period that we have let down in. Been real happy with how hard our guys have been playing. We took a couple penalties. The delay of game penalty when you shoot the puck up over the glass, can't really help that. But other than that, we got to start staying out of the box because it's only one goal game and we don't want to let these guys get any points.
Well, we got 20 minutes to go. Let's see what happens. Third period coming up. Comets only lead it by one, 1-0.
Comet fans, you want to listen a little bit more beyond Comet Game of the Week on Wednesday nights on Access Fort Wayne? We have a new show on WELT produced by the Comets called Cometcast.
I am your host, Shane Alberani. You know me from doing the play-by-play on WoWo throughout the season, but now I'm adding podcast host to the old resume. Keep an eye out on social media, Twitter, and Facebook for who our next guest is going to be.
Join Shane Tuesday mornings at 9 a.m. for Cometcast on WELT.
And we're back with hopefully the start of period number three and talking to David and Michael Franke out front. And Michael made a statement, we've had these big crowds. We've not won with these big crowds in here. And these are, like Doug and I said before, these are the ones you got to win when you got a lot of newbies in there in the upper decks and stuff. And like David said, well, we've already had one fight. Now if we just get a win out of the game, we'll be all happy.
Well, and that's a very good point. When I was walking back up, there was a family going out, and they probably had about 10, 12 little girls that were together for a birthday party. So it's events like this that bring in that part of the crowd.
Well, Scott Sproat's done a great job of the promotions and the marketing of this hockey club, and Comets need to win this one handedly. Nice shot. See if we can't keep it in play. Binkley goes all the way around to
good
the far
job.
Side. Out to the, oh, that's kind of, oh, that's scary. Petruccelli playing a little bit of the point action there. Comets on the power play. Binkley, shot. He saw it all the way. No whistle yet. And the referee right there.
Yeah, the goalie had lost the puck. So and again, that's what we need to do because this goalie, as well as he's played, he's been fighting the puck at times. And we need to take advantage of one of these times where the puck squirts loose that we
be
chop
right there
it
to
in.
Pick it up. That's right.
The one thing I can say is the Rapid City defensemen are doing a great job on tying up our sticks so that we can't get to the loose puck.
Well, another long-time, old-time great, Barry Scully scored a lot of goals from right there just the top of that blue paint. 69, I think, in one year.
He did.
And that's where he liked to play. He liked to play in that.
Well, there's a lot of players that don't want to go in that area because you're going to get chopped, you're going to get punched and hit. And there's a lot of players that won't pay the price.
Nice wrist shot.
Oh, if it's on net, it's in.
Lowney. Nice save, too, by Lowney. Diving save. Oh, it just took a little bit too long there. If you could have got it off quicker. That's going to be one-on-one here. Comet's coming back. Oh, that's going to go up in the netting. Should be a face-off inside the Comet zone.
A good effort by Lowney to keep that puck in on the far side. We got the pass to Campagna, but like you said, he just couldn't release it as quick as he normally did. And by the time he did, one of their players got a piece of the stick on it.
Reminds me of the movie Slapshot when we talk about Scully. Scully liked to have a few beers here and there, and I think the Chiefs are playing Hyannisport or something. They come in there, and that one guy's still drunk and talking about, hey, don't hit me because I might just wet myself. I was thinking Scully when the guy does that.
Yeah, Scully.
He liked his beverages. Boy, right there in front.
Good job on driving to the net. Their goaltender's stood his ground and stayed onto the post and didn't let the puck squirt through. But I really liked the fact that we drove to the net hard. I think it was Shaw.
Yeah, Brady Shaw's really came out like gangbusters. He's been pretty consistent, but he's not been scoring as much as I'd like to see him. He got 17 on the season, though. But
well, he did start out hot, but other teams are really keen in on him,
oh,
and he's
yeah.
not getting the open chances.
They know what he's capable of doing. Taking it back there is Wasilowski off the boards. Trying to get off the boards anyway.
Ooh,
oh,
got
boy,
lucky
right in
there.
Front. Here we
now
go.
Let's make him pay. Put it on net.
Ciro, nice job there as he took it to the net. Did the old toe drag out to the point. Oh, I like that. Got rid of it real quick as Binkley on the point. Ah. Got deflected there.
Got deflected in front of the net. A good deflection.
Oh. Nice save. And
our defenseman got turned inside out by number 14. Very skilled player for them, but Levine come up with the probably going to be the save of the game.
Yeah, only their 17th shot on the net, but great save as Levine did the old splits and put the old catcher's mitt up there. Good save.
Nice save. And that's what you need from your goaltending.
And it's tough too, Doug, when you're not getting a lot of action that you stay fresh and stay on track there.
That stay focused and
it's all just getting
turned inside out
there.
Didn't know where the puck was, and
here's Saul after it now. Controls a little bit. I'd like to see him go off and off the boards.
Yeah,
a little
quicker, and they got their stick on it. They're putting a little pressure on us.
Ooh, nice deflection there.
Campagna
with it. They slow it down. Comet's going for a
didn't
change.
Get it all the way in. Bad change. I think Sid thought it was going to go in deeper than it did.
Here goes Wah after it, just kind of out of step on it. As Wasilowski goes back to pick it up.
Yeah, we got to pick up the pace a little bit, put some more pressure on him.
Ooh, nice kick save.
Good and job by
out.
Wah back checking and tying up the stick.
16:50 to go in the period. Picking it up is Llewellyn. Yep.
Seskon. Llewellyn loves to do the cheap shots, but Seskon just grabbed him by the face and threw him down. Yeah, like I was telling you, a couple of my former players in that and son-in-law were asking when we have our games. I think they wanted to critique it so they can see if I'm using the same lines as when I was coaching.
Why not? Those were good lines.
Yeah, but they got tired of hearing them.
Probably a little more docile compared to what in those days.
I'm sure. Or they want to check, see what shirt I was wearing. I had one shirt that I wore that used to say I looked like a assistant manager from a McDonald's, so that was the last time that shirt ever got worn.
That's nice. Ooh, off the boards, though. Just couldn't control it there. As they bring it deep. Only one goal deficit here.
It's going to be an icing.
Need to get one on the board here. With 16:28 to go in period number three. 34-20 as shots on goal. Face off the right of goaltender Tyler Parks. Again, their goaltender 6'7", 230.
Another goal would be really nice to have.
Crunk in the corner. Being held up there a little bit by Elms.
Yeah, 13 and 14 that are not that big. I'm sure we're going to try doing something to see if they can get Crunk suckered into a penalty, but he's not that type of player.
No. Binkley after it. Nice off the boards. Nice kick job there. Just get outside the blue line.
Well, the nice thing was Binkley knew he was going to take a hit.
Into the corner. As the referee gets out of the way there.
Here we go.
Camras with it in the corner. Went down. Well, good move there. We're trying to push the play there.
Sid?
Oh, they're going to give it to us on that one. Thank you. And they'll have a penalty.
Yeah, I'd say that was a pretty weak call, but we'll take it.
Yeah.
You know, there's a couple that they had on us earlier in the game that was a little questionable that I call that one of the makeups, but now we just have to take advantage of it.
Yeah, that's Coyne going back to the box. He's been there a lot tonight. I think he's had a five and a couple twos.
And I'm pretty sure he played in Kalamazoo.
Yeah, I think that does sound pretty good. That does sound pretty good.
I see their guy trying to plead the case to the ref to no avail.
Yep.
What Josh, is called?
Josh Elms.
Goal here would be a big, big help.
Oh, boy, if we could get one here. One power play goal would be great. Petroselli comes back in deep. Petroselli gets it back.
Walk out.
Nobody in front. Oh, that was
nice
beautiful
save.
Play, though.
Nice save.
Beautiful play.
If the goalie wasn't a southpaw.
Oh.
If he wasn't a southpaw, he would have made that save. It would have been up over his blocker.
Great job by Shaw, though. He just held on to it long enough. Oh, broke a stick.
No slash.
A little bit of a slash there, and they didn't call it. Broke his stick pretty well.
Broke it in half.
So, I think it'd be.
Do you think David wants to send him a bill for $200 for that stick?
I think so. They're expensive. Oh, here goes on the far side. Wrist shot.
And again, he was squeezing his arm.
Good shot by Campagna on the left side.
Yeah, he's got such a heavy shot, too. And when people hear us talking about heavy shot, just the weight of the shot, a lot of times when you gotta have a heavy shot, he can put it through arms where the guy has it in place. Well, we got our
security police officer, sheriff, up there doing a little bit of dance.
And he's got his Harry Potter glasses on, yeah. Much to the delight of the crowd.
Face off to the left of goaltender Tyler Parks is a Rapid City gets possession of it. They're trying to kill this penalty off with 35 seconds to go. Nothing's going to hurt you more than getting a shorthanded goal.
And we've given a few of those up.
Well, you talk about those heavy shots, and I know what you're saying. And a guy way before you, Merv Dubček, was a right winger that would come down that right side, and probably about twice a year he'd run through the end of the rink, into the boards. But he was had a great slap shot, and that's where he scored 72 goals one year.
That's insane.
That is insane. I thought 40. I'd been happy with 44, but 72 was just unbelievable. And 90% of them were his big slap shot. It was just, oh, my gosh.
Yeah, he was just one of those all-time Comet greats.
Or number 15. Out to the point. Sidlowski. Oh!
Trying to get two perfect. Get back. Now we're
3-on-1.
4-on-2.
Oh, and nice shot. Top corner.
And just like that, where it's 1-1 game.
Comet's out shooting him 37-21. And we just can't put him away. Went out and collected that puck. Must have been his first goal.
Is that coin? Or cone or coin or whatever? But he did. He just put it right up under the crossbar.
Yeah, it's coin's first of the season.
But we've been talking about it that, you know, we don't bury a second goal. We keep letting them have a chance, and they keep believing because their goaltender's giving them the chance. Now they tied it up. 13 minutes left. We're playing well. We just got to keep going.
Well, it's tied up, so we'll see how bad we want to win this one. They waved that off. No icing. Come around on their side. Oh, just about. And the referee helping out a little bit there, brought it back behind the net. Just dumping it in was Elms. Saul, got to be sure with the puck. Now we're getting outworked here right now, Doug.
They got a player that's down on the far side. I don't know what happened to him. But he definitely looked like he got run over.
Looks like number 20, Lambert.
The way he's bent over, I'm thinking he got run.
Yeah.
Into the private areas.
Left a stick there and everything. He was wanting to get off.
But we just got to pick up the pace a little bit. Rapid City has got the momentum going right now.
Finishing off here. There we go. Good effort there. Nice dump in. Going after it. Yeah, that's one way to go after it. Little hold, no call. Keeping it in the zone.
Smart play by Shasma.
Hit the linesman. Bringing it back. Binkley with it. Right down the middle, knocked it down. Shasma just out of the reach. They called that onside. Nice deflection. Not able to get a hold of Wazowski. Does now. They get it back. Oh, well, that was close. That was close. I saw that. I'm sure Otto picked that up.
That was very close. 18 was coming in to argue it, but heck, he was out at the blue line, so I have no idea what he was going to argue.
Comet's out shooting him only 39-23.
We had 21 after the first period, so you know, Rapid City has really tightened up their defense the last two periods.
Definitely picked it up.
It's not how many shots you have, it's how many you score. So all that's important now, we just tuck one or two here and put them away.
Sean Sadowski goes right down the middle. Both going after it. In the corner deep. Campagna getting a little fancy stuff out in front. Ah. Still got a hold of it. Chasma.
I think that's Sid.
Oh, Sid. Okay. Yeah, you're right. Sid.
I just going by the way he was skating.
Yeah. As Rapid City brings it in. Oh, there we go. Stay with his man.
Normally, Turner can
nice save
bulldoze
there.
His way past just about anybody, but Sescon had the angle on him.
Sadowski just draws everybody to him and then lightly throws it in. 10-22.
Just so smart.
10-22 to go. Nice poke check. I like that. And it's Binkley now. Dumps it in.
No icing.
Nice job on the blue line. Kept it in, but lost possession of it. Offside. Well, right now, the Comets have picked it up as far as possession goes. Just got to do something with it. Wow. Oh, I wish he'd have gone to the middle. Tried bringing it with him. Oh, I don't want it. You take it. Comets go for partial change.
And also with it being new ice, because ice was taken out for all the circus and everything.
That's right.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, I'll take it with that. Stay onside. There we go. Ciro trying to make it move there. Oh, right in front. No one home.
Well, it went off the backside of our player.
Ciro being held off. No call.
Well, the good thing tonight is our guys on no calls are not getting all wound up about it.
Oh. No holding? Come on. Oh, geez. That was pretty obvious. Oh, man. Ah.
Trying to get too fancy.
Yep. Saw there was a good possibility for nice play there, but just Sescon back to pick it up. Off the boards. Nice job. Just, oh, yeah, I was just hoping to poke it in there. No offside. That surprised me.
They looked pretty offside to me, but no call.
Me too. Lambert with it, going into the left side. Nice job of hanging on to the post.
Another, got to be smart, Sescon. Can't take a penalty, but chopped his stick right in half in his hands.
Referee might be doing away with the whistle this last part of the period. Tied up. And he's going to hang on to that. Good idea. With 7:23 to go, Doug, and they definitely picked it up a little bit. I thought the Comets were starting to pick it up a little bit more and then trying to get too fancy down in your offensive zone.
Yeah, with this goalie, the way he's playing, we just need to start throwing everything at it. I like the idea that they're trying to hit Sadlowski in the slot. There's not a whole lot of room because Rapid City's collapsing everybody down in front of the net to take that passing shot away, and especially wherever Sid's going to be, he's going to have company. But it's going to be almost like an ugly goal is going to be the next goal. You know.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I just don't want the Comets to wait the last minute to get on the board again. Yeah, Rapid City's not going to wait any.
No, Rapid City's right where they want to be. They got a tie game. They're playing for the tie, hoping to get the extra point. But all they're looking at is, hey, if we can get at least a point out of this, it's the start of a good road trip.
Again, a night we've got a good crowd in here. We need to pull a win out of this one.
You know, and that is an interesting fact that this year with big crowds, we haven't performed well as far as getting wins. Some games we've played very well, lost in overtime or something, but it'd go a long way for the marketing department. We finished this game off strong.
Well, as Tina Franke said, if you can't get up for playing in front of a crowd like this, you probably have no business playing hockey.
Well, in Rapid City, you know, every team loves coming in here because they know it's going to be a good crowd.
Sure they do. Good shot wide. Lajoie deep off the boards. Nice. Keep it. Couldn't control it. Like the effort, though. Waugh cuts him off. Binkley gets it. A little too close there.
You know, Rapid City putting a lot of pressure on. Here we got some speed going up the boards.
Done left side. Nice wrist shot. Gets it delivered.
And I liked how he cut into the middle after he took the shot, went to the front of the net, and stopped.
Well, they'll come when you start doing that. I mean, it's not always successful, but they'll.
But those
keep
are the great habits to have at any level. You know, squirts all the way up to the NHL, that if you're doing that, sooner or later you're going to get a break, and all of a sudden the puck's going to be there and you can tuck it in.
Well, it's old-time hockey. You know, you even listen to Eddie Olczyk on NBC. He'll talk about a lot of those things like you do about for the kids and stuff, and exactly the same thing that you're saying. He's saying at the NHL level, hey, you got to go to the net.
Yeah, like we talked, people don't like going to the net because you're going to get hit.
Got to pay the price. Ooh, that was a blast. And up in the netting.
And their number 21 paid the price on blocking the shot so it doesn't get through. You know, and that's when we're talking about the little things. It's stuff like that where nobody wants to block a shot because it can really hurt with some of these guys the way they shoot. You know, so when guys are doing that, you know that they're trying to help their team win in any way possible.
Well, especially with the equipment you used to wear. I know that it was terrible when I played. It was nice wrist shot. Well, just get in the area.
This line is really buzzing.
Tussle back.
Good check by their defenseman.
Off the boards. Whoa! A little close there.
Yeah, their player didn't play the puck when he's coming off. There we go. Spread out a little bit, guys.
Oh, nice boy. Shot. That was a good play there.
Baptiste made a nice play. It'd been real nice if he would have been able to elevate it about 6 inches. It would have been over his. Oh,
Leonid Sidlowski goes after it.
There
Sidlowski
we go.
Gets it back.
Good body position.
Trying to free
get
it
someone
up.
There to help out.
Oh. Mounty back to pick it up. Nice job onside. Campagna, nice pass. Oh, just about freed it up.
That's where you need that guy off that side for the rebound.
Comets pick it off there. Nice off the boards. Campagna picks it up. Oh, got the wheels. Got one with him. Oh, he tried going. It's going to be face-off inside. They knocked it down. I don't think he was assisted when he went into the net.
Lost an edge. And
Leibinger lost an edge and took that net away. Talk about that net. A lot of times people don't realize when you played, those pipes were into the cement and did not move.
No, they did not. Seen many a guy mess up their knees. And
Yeah, they're on a little magnet type of setup there that
and in some cases, they break off a little too easy at times.
Yeah, yeah. As goaltenders have been known to push off on that post.
Whatever advantage you can have.
Out to the point. Saul get a shot off there as they're... Comets.
That went in. That was in.
I missed it.
Yeah, Turner didn't like he got clipped or something.
Yeah, I'll tell you, it sure looked like it was in. It was quick, the top corner, and it came out.
Yeah, it looked like it just went inside the post.
At least the referee is in there conferring with the officials. I'm not sure what the protocol is here. I mean, I know in the NHL they've got a group of people watching it up in New York, I believe. And
right now we only have a few.
Well, usually when they come out of the, they point to the center faceoff right away if it's a goal. And I don't like this too much. No goal. I'm saying Otto. Well.
They must say it hit the post or something. I don't know. It looked awfully close to me. But we're not one of the rinks that have the replay set up. There's, I think, Kalamazoo, Toledo.
Yeah, I know there's
a few. And there's like two others.
Which I don't understand why. If it's not league-wide, why would it even be considered?
Exactly. That I'm not sure. So we just got to keep going.
That's right. Realize we can do it again. Do it again. Into the corner. Oh. We kept it in possession. That's good. Nice move by Sidlowski behind the net there. Oh, what was...
Got to get back. Got to keep it down low.
On the boards. Well, nobody with him is... Camras passed it off.
Yeah, Chasma went off for a change, which is a smart change on his part. Yeah. Get some fresh legs out there. Tipped over by Sidlowski.
4 minutes even to go in the period.
Yeah, this ref has definitely put his whistle away.
Camras went down pretty hard there. Picking it up is Mercier in the corner. Oh, God. Wow. Well, he's going to hang on to that. I thought we might want to keep it moving. 3:37 to go in period number three, tied up, one apiece.
You know, there's a lot of people that were asking if Hafner was going to get another chance here. You know, it seems his confidence down. Levine's been playing well. You know, Hafner has been our number one goalie with
Fucali called up,
so we need two good goaltenders.
Well, as forwards play, sometimes the bottom falls out for forward. He's scoreless with number of games or whatever, but same way for a goaltender, just
a lot of times for a goaltender, it's just all mental,
yeah,
not physical.
Binkley, near side. Sidlowski off the boards. Yes. Ah! We keep it in. Binkley with it. Boy, that's a nice shot there.
This line is due.
Here's Binkley on the near side. Well, he's going to try to get that held up there as 3:02 is left in the period.
You know, I like the mentality of this line. I feel that it's just going to be a matter of time for them, that they're getting some good chances. Now they're just starting to throw the puck. And each of them are great shooters and dangerous. You know, Sadlowski, Campagna, and Baptista. And it's almost like it's going to be an ugly goal that's going to win this game.
Well, you got to say they're throwing on the end. The Comets got 43 shots. That's very complimentary.
You know, and we're getting a lot of good quality shots.
Off the boards.
No good icing. Job by Seskon. Whoa, blue wheel.
That's all right. Got it outside anyway.
Nope.
On the near side. Out to the point. 2:22 to go. Got deflected.
That one hurt.
Got deflected.
That shot was blocked, and Waugh is getting off.
They're going to call that icing. Comes all the way back. 2:11 to go. Well, I sure don't want to see overtime. Don't want to see overtime.
Well, we did manage to get one change. Waugh, who blocked the shot, should have stayed out, and he went off hurt down to the training room, so no one questioned it.
Hopefully he's okay.
Well, I'm sure he is. It was smart, but the important thing was we got a fresh set of legs out there, someone that's not kind of nicked up.
Zero off the boards. Dumping it in. Shastma going after it. Good hit. Keeping it inside. Saw with a big boomer. And again, keeping it in there.
It was Gibson.
Doing a good job there. They waved that off. High stick. Ooh, nice save. Went to the net. Minute and a half to go in the period.
Good job by Saul winning that battle. Got good body position.
Force that play. Force him. Camras after it.
Got good speed.
They drop it off. Minute 15 to go. Sadlowski putting the offensive pressure on. Oh, man, that was the opportunity there.
This line's going to score one. Would have liked to seen a little shorter pass, but.
Yeah.
Keep knocking them down.
Yeah, I just ready to say, looked over the referee, and that's all we need to get a penalty right now.
The way he's put his whistle away the last 10 minutes.
Onside. Keep it in there. Well, they'll be happy to get it out and go into overtime. 22 seconds to go. Goes wide.
Let's make one more rush.
Thank you, Otto.
Why not have overtime on a Saturday night?
That's right. That looks like it's what's going to be here. It's going to go into overtime. 1-1. Comets out shooting the Rapid City Rush 44-25.
Woo! Well, the thing is, we've been playing well. Their goaltender kept them in the game. They got one good scoring chance, and they buried it. Beautiful shot up underneath the crossbar. I'm sure Levine would love to have that one back. You know, it was a good shot. It wasn't a cheap goal. So, and we had our scoring chances. We had one that they disallowed.
Very questionable.
Have to look to see if it did make it inside the post or if it just hit the post and came out. So, but we don't have a replay here in this building, so it's kind of tough to call.
What is amazing how the way the net is that if it went in, it should have stayed in for the most part or kind of bounced out funny. But that one kind of looked like went on the post or crossbar, I should say, came right back out. But
well, and a lot of people don't understand, the people even that work for the Comets that are doing the video and everything up there, as much as they want the Comets to win, they have a job to do. And they're going to say exactly what is on the tape, show them, and just go from there. They're not just going to be homers.
Very impartial.
Because they have a job to do, and they do a very good job at it. And a lot of them have been doing it for many years. Some of them from even way back when I played.
Oh, yes. Yep.
Which is amazing to my son because he thinks all fans have passed away from when I played.
Oh, yeah. And your in-laws, they were great Comet fans before you got here.
Yeah, Davey Norris was an adopted son to him.
Three on three. Comets should have the edge here. No sooner I say something like that than I'll get stuck at it. So hopefully I didn't hex him. Here's Wah. Took that big shot here before. Still have possession.
Good job on having puck control.
Oh, that was a giveaway.
Well,
he wanted to go off the boards, I think, a little bit harder.
He thought Lowney was going to be turning one way, and Lowney went the other way.
Comets go for partial change there.
Usually happens. One team will have a good scoring chance, and if they don't score, come all the way back. And Rapid City pulling it back so they get some fresh players out.
You know, Comets,
doing the same thing.
Got a nice overtime win in Indianapolis. Oh, it just goes wide. 3 seconds into the overtime, Petrocelli scored that goal. Oh, what a chance!
Yeah, their defenseman robbed that puck. If he makes it over onto the side.
Comets still have control of it. Batista in the corner, comes out. Binkley with it. Binkley, very defensive-minded defenseman.
A lot of chopping.
So he's don't want to get caught there. Oh! He's going to hang on to it. When you're making that big swoop out there on the far on the blue line, you don't want to get
the puck
lost
poked
there.
Away.
And then they're gone. Get a one on up, nothing there. Didn't hear what the crowd was. Did you hear, Otto? Oh, they're calling it a sellout tonight. Well, that's good. Good.
So now all we have to do is just finish it off. We got Sidlowski, Capania.
He's going to hang on to that. It's a smart decision there, I'd say.
Yeah, a lot of firepower out there right now.
Yeah, this would be the group.
We got Sid. We got Capania. Who do we have back on defense?
It looks like Phillips.
Okay.
Kind of surprising, but if he can handle the puck. Capania puts a little pressure on there.
Now it's Rapid City's chance to have the puck, and everyone picks up a man.
High on the blue line. Sidlowski kind of letting him go there. That went up into the netting. There'll be a face-off inside the zone.
Again, Rapid City just throwing the puck at the net, trying to catch Levine off balance, not paying attention, but he was right on it.
Oh, boy.
They got a little bit of everything that pops up on the scoreboard.
They sure do. Face off the left of Eric Levine. Came in here tonight with a 2.77 goals against after six starts. Nice job when the control there by Schasma.
Good face off. Schasma come back to pick up the puck.
Maybe. There we go.
Or fake them out to get them moving.
Oh, got deflected.
Oh, almost caught him napping.
Yeah, it did. And lets it come outside the blue line. Get it set up again. Going for partial change there. Lowney brings it back.
Ooh, dangerous.
Yeah,
almost
is.
Too many men.
You got those wheels. Petrucelli going to the net. Oh, boy. How did he? Oh, nuts. Mm.
Yeah, just got it poked away from him at the last second.
He's got some wheels, doesn't he?
He does.
Oh, my
gosh. Here
we
go.
Ooh, nice move. The old toe drag. Oh, going wide. Got deflected.
There's an ice.
No, they waved it off. Here's Gibson down the back, bringing it up. On the far side. Shaw just getting, just about getting pulled down.
Uh-oh. Oh,
turn on those jets. Oh, this is not good.
Good back
Thank
check.
You. Yeah, absolutely.
Good back check.
38 seconds, enough
here
time
we
to
go.
Enough time for a little run here. If we're not too tired. 29 seconds. Oh, man. What a great move.
Yeah, Shaw was just gassed. He'd been out there quite a while, but that would have been real sweet with that move if he could have finished it off. But again, the fans are seeing a lot of great hockey tonight.
I made a note for Otto. Maybe we can show that move by Shaw there with
Yeah, there's not a lot of players
seconds.
That can pull that one off.
That was a great move there.
Yeah,
a great comeback, great
there.
Back check there. They could have easily gone on the winner's column on that one. Woo!
But Levine was right on the guy all the way in.
Oh, yeah.
And as he was making his move past him, and then here's, you're going to show it right there.
Oh. Just about was successful on the backhand pass. Was he wide open or not? Oh, my gosh.
It would have been nice if he would have been able to get that shot off a little bit quicker, but great move by him.
Well, thank you, Otto, for showing the replay on that one. Otto likes to slow him down once in a while, too, just like they did on the big screen there. And
so we win the faceoff here, take a shot, score, and go home.
There you go. There you go. Hockey's made a lot of changes throughout its existence. Not always wild about some of the changes, but this is exciting. Nice move by Sadlowski. Oh.
Right up off his shoulder.
7 seconds to go.
Yeah, they're
it's
just
gonna
playing
go into
for,
a shootout.
They're just playing for a shootout. Yeah, Sadlowski was going for that top corner. And one thing when you got a goalie this size, he's still gonna cover a lot of the top of the net when he goes down. Now, let's just win it in a shootout.
Oh boy. No, people are getting their money's worth tonight. Getting those extra.
Yeah, for all those new fans here, they're going to think, well, this is just the normal way the hockey game's supposed to go. I mean, they've seen goals. They've seen great goaltending, good play by both teams, the fight.
Yeah, one good punch, Otto says.
You know, so now we just have to finish it off strong in the shootout.
Yeah, I don't know how you feel about some things like the removal of the red line and some of the other things that hockey is. It seems like hockey is one of the few sports that is always making changes almost every year. But I got to admit, it is exciting in the overtime to 3-on-3. It's exciting. I'd still would rather see go with an overtime, 10-minute overtime or whatever. And if it's over, if it's still tied, then it's tied. But here's Sean going out with the first shot. Come on, Sean. Oh, got deflected, I think, went up in the...
Well, with a goalie this size, you got to get him moving side to side, to, or he's going to be pretty tough to beat. Now it's our goaltender's time to shine.
Here's Farna with it. And he scores.
Nice move. Again, he got our goaltender moving side to side. Wasn't quite sure what he was going to be doing. He kept skating and released a quick wrist shot.
There's Campagna. You're going to see a quick release, whatever it is, I would think. There it is. Quick release.
That quick release, 5-all. But again, he got him moving a little bit, and then he releases that puck so quick the goalie got a piece of it, but he couldn't get his stick down hard enough to stop it.
That's like Brian Gratz, former goaltender and former coach, said once he sees those guys stop moving their feet, he gets ready for the shot. Campagna didn't do it. He keeps his feet moving. And that was a score. Ah, gone, boys. Making it hard for us.
Yeah, we got a score here to keep it going. There's something they definitely see on Levine. They're beating him to the stick side.
Brady Shaw with the opportunity here to keep this going.
And Rapid City wins.
Yep. Another one, Comets in the losing bracket there.
And unfortunately, the streak continues for big crowds. And I think this is probably the third time we've lost either in a shootout or an overtime with a big crowd. So Comets go on the road for the next three games. Rapid City stole a game. I figure their goalie is the one should be the number one star because he made it possible.
Well, you play in front of average 2,600 people when you come into a 10,000-seat arena and pull out a shootout. That's pretty impressive.
Yeah, they got to be real happy with the way this road trip is for them. They got the 2 points. The one good thing is we at least got one. You know, but, you know, it's still not one that will sit well with the coaching staff or anything. Just because I felt we played very well.
You know, Shafts over there talking to their captain and probably know each other from years gone by.
Yep, probably played together at Allen, and so I'm not even sure who their captain was, number 8?
Number 8, yep. Actually, it must be number 9.
Is it 9?
Must be 9.
Okay.
Well, he's not even on the list. Anyway, tough loss for the Comets. Big crowd in here on the Harry Potter night. Unfortunately, they could not pull one off. So for Doug Gleeger, myself, Randy Markham, and Otto Boucher behind the camera, Comets lose 2-1 in a shootout. We'll be back again next week with another Common Hockey Game of the Week.